Hey everybody, how you doing? It's showtime. Welcome to the party, pals. Nice to have you here. It's Stock Markets with Bruce is the name of the channel. I'm Uncle Bruce. That's what they call me. And Charlie C is a brand new member of this channel. Gold bagel level right here, right now. Welcome to the party, Charlie. Nice to have you here. Welcome one and all to the show this morning. We're just waiting for the unemployment report number to come out. It may have already popped. I'm not sure. Just going to double check here. Waiting for the number to be released. A headline says here, one in five U.S. workers think their jobs are pointless. Yeah, I'm going to say one in three workers, one in two and a half workers believe they are completely underappreciated by their managers and are considered fodder. How about that? Yeah, I would say so. What do you think the job satisfaction level is with most people's jobs out there? How happy are they to be part of the organization they're part of? Going to be interesting going forward. The United Auto Workers is going after a new contract. 40% raises expected, going for 40% more money over the next 4 years. So that's 10% a year, maybe 12% the first year, 9% the second year, and then, you know, 7.5%, 8% after that. Going to be interesting. Among other things, they're going after increased benefits for retirees who took massive cuts. They're looking for reinstatement of all kinds of perks that were taken away last time, because the last time they did the auto companies a favor by helping them out. Well, chief top executives of auto companies have had more than 40% raises the last 3 years, and the UAE is going, now it's our turn. You guys have had the good times. Now we want some of that action too. And it is going to be an interesting time. Just waiting for and looking to see if and what the job thing is. Here it is. U.S. job gains in May lowered to 281 from 306. U.S. job gains revised downward to 185 from 209 for June. The U.S. work week drops by 1/10 of an hour in July. U.S. wages rise 0.4% in July. U.S. unemployment rate drops to 3.5% in July from 3.6. U.S. economy creates 187 new jobs in July below forecast. There you go. There it is. And now what will this mean to the market? Will the market be happy about the fact that the jobless number, jobs created, was lower? Is the market going to go, oh, this is great. Lower jobs created than thought. This is great. Other job creation numbers for other markets are lower. Hey, maybe the Fed will reduce rates even sooner than before. And maybe it'll have a knee-jerk reaction to the upside. The Dow's up 6 points, 8 points. We'll see if this has any effect. I don't know if it'll have much of an effect at all. It's really about how much money are we making. I got to tell you, though, this United Auto Workers deal that's coming up, if Powell... Chairman Powell from the Federal Reserve has a hope to get to the 2% unemployment number. I got bad news for him. It's not going to happen with a 40% demand for labor increases from the UAW. That's not going to do it. We're going to have three companies, Ford, GM, and Stellantis or whatever it's Chrysler called now, what a stupid name. Those three guys are all under the same contract. And that is a million plus workers. I don't know how many, hundreds of thousands. Then we're going to have all the suppliers to the automotive business, all the parts makers, all the advisory services firms that supply the auto industry with parts and services. They're all going to be under a huge pressure as well. We're going to have labor unrest here, because I don't see in a month from now a negotiated deal that's going to work. I think the car companies are going to put up squawk. I think they're going to go running to Washington with their tails between their legs and seek help from their favorite senators and favorite congressmen to try to do a legislation back to work of some kind. They're going to try to find a way to politically make it very difficult for the UAW to get what they want. Because after all, who funds the super PACs? The unions? corporations. And we're going to see how this all plays out. In any event, there'll be some companies that will make labor peace, others will not, and we'll find out. But at the end of the day, if the auto workers get they get a 12% raise the first year, and they get a 10% raise the second year, and they get an 8% raise the third year, and an 8% the fourth year, and that works out to about 40% or something like that, this is not going to help inflation to get down to 2%. That's just not going to happen. And so there's the dilemma. Who is the party? What group has to pay the biggest price in pain, economic pain, to get inflation down to 2%? And I know the answer. I don't know if you know the answer, but I know the answer. Pick me. I know. Labor. Labor always loses. Labor is viewed by corporations as a very necessary and painful expense. It is not viewed as a partner in greatness. Corporations have a funny habit of exploiting labor to as hard as they can get it to get as much out of labor as possible, and then blame labor for their problems and only give their executives kudos for a job well done. And then, of course, the shareholders benefit. Look, shareholders and boards of directors and other key people will say to a corporation, you have to reduce your expenses. You have to improve your margins. Well, what's your number one expense? Well, for some companies, it's like fuel for the jet airline companies. Cruise lines, fuel. But for General Motors, number one expense, labor. Walmart, number one expense, labor. And so there you go. The problem right now for labor, even with today's job market report, there isn't enough labor to go around. There are companies in the United States who pray every day that somehow, some way, someone's going to walk through the front door and apply for a job that can show an American passport, that I'm a bona fide American. I may look like a typical American, or I may not look like a typical American. I might have a color to my facial hue here that doesn't spell or scream that I'm an American, but I have a passport or I have a green card. These companies are dying for anyone to walk through their front door with a green card, a legal reason to be in the U.S. to work. And they're not getting those people because there's a shortage of labor. And that's the bottom line. If unemployment is 3.5% right now, after this jobs report has been released, there's a recession going on. Labor people can't find jobs if they leave. I don't think so. The UAE is in a position for the first time in many, many, many years to say to the car industry, you need us more than we need you. Every one of our members can quit and go to get a job somewhere else like that. Maybe not in this town that we're in right now, that the city, the location here in Ohio or Pennsylvania or Illinois or Indiana, wherever we happen to be, we might not find a job exactly in this town. But you know what? COVID has taught us something that we never thought would exist and would be at least 10 years from now, and it's happening today. There are UAW workers who can work from home. They have skills. They've also raised their skill levels because in the old days, in the 60s and the 50s, you see all these films of how they made cars. And you had a guy putting bolts on a tire. You had a guy, you know, opening and closing a door to see if it worked. There were a lot of jobs back in the day where a car came off an assembly line, there were thousands of workers for every car that came off the assembly line. Today, there are hundreds of workers for every car, or maybe 1,000, but not 3,000 or 5,000. It is a far lower number of workers per car coming off the assembly line, and the vehicles are far more sophisticated. And that's because car factories are just assembly points. And the UAW guys, they've had to up their skill game to do more functional jobs. They don't do the one menial job anymore. They can get a job doing other stuff and walking away. And at $18 starting wage, have you been paying attention out there? How much minimum wage jobs are now paying, or how much a job at Starbucks pays, or McDonald's, or other, you know, I mean, Walmart, Target, Costco jobs. There are jobs paying more than $18 an hour or paying awful damn close to that kind of money. And you don't have to work in a car factory. I mean, hey, labor has got it on right now over employers. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's going to be interesting to see what happens. Anyway, welcome all to the show here. 10 minutes in, we are looking at a 44-point gain on the Dow Jones right now. We've got the S&P 500 ahead now 12 points. We've got job creation number 187,000 as the unemployment rate keeps dropping. Watching to see how the markets are going to fare. 10-point gain on S&P, 49-point gain on NASDAQ. Oil is up 43 cents a barrel. So there you go. A positive spin on the initial reaction to the job market. Charlie, welcome. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the gang. It's great to have you. Stephen Butler is here this morning. How you doing, pal? Richard Carlin, as always, Lame Duck. Splair's here. Hector's here. How you guys doing? Welcome all. This is great. JR, it's option expiry day. Let's make that moolah. Deep Value is here. Robert is here. I'm thumbs up 18. I'll see you Monday night. You got it, buddy. Thank you, my friend. Lobo, Lordo is here. How you doing? JR, Dean, DH Ruda, Luca is in the house. How's it going, everybody? Hector's here. Wing Commander, John Anderson, Bama Babe, Charlie, new member, looming listener. Since Uncle Bruce was doing the 8-hour broadcast, I appreciate all of the stock guidance and insights. Welcome, my friend. Holmes Skillet, Luca, Matthew, Lorraine, Drew, look at the thumbs ups coming in here. Look at them coming in. Amy, sell my house fast. Current Karen is here. Nice to see you here. A shrinking workforce, says Stephen Butler, with increased demand to fill slots and a recession are not necessarily mutually exclusive sets. Not enough young folks to replace the old folks. There you go. Bjorn is here. How you doing, Bjorn? From Sweden. Welcome, my friend. Good to see you. Splayer is here. By the way, Bjorn, Jennifer and I are going to be in Stockholm. We're coming to Stockholm. Should we do a meet and greet in Stockholm? Should we gather up 50 people to get together and see us in Stockholm? We're coming. Looking forward to it. Splayer, somehow sad that a USMC McDonald's, US McDonald's worker gets 25 to 50% more than most Germans lower class. Amazing. Beach Boy, Bruce, Red Bruce. Hey, how you doing? Good day, Beach Boy. Cindy, good morning. And Karim, good morning, y'all. Hi, nice to see you all. Good day, good morning. I figure I'll wear a red shirt, make the market go green. I'll just do the opposite, you see. Go from there. Now, look, behind me, I've written something down here. You're kind of wondering, what's he doing? A number of you are beginning to understand that now you're taking Class 16, which, by the way, is available now on the website. You can get your edited version right now on the website. Head on over there. Those of you who were here last Saturday, you hung out with me for the class, and then you got your edited version a couple of days ago. Now the rest of you can get your own copy. And those of you who have seen the class have been inspired by Iron Condor writing. And one of the Iron Condor strategies is you can write Iron Condors on the stock market itself, the actual index. Now the SPY index is the standard and poor, the S&P 500. That's what it actually is. And the range of the S&P 500, the SPY ETF that tracks the index, is 1/10 the value of the index. So for the last week, the range has been $447 a unit to $457 a unit without the pennies. I took the pennies out of it. To give you an idea, the stock market ranged in the last 5 days, $10 a unit on the SPY. So if you're going to write a condor, you're going to do a condor position, you have to be aware of this. You also have to be aware of this. This is the 52-week high for the condors, for the S&P, 459.44, and the 52-week low is 348.11. Now, we do not see highs and lows within a week of each other or even a month of each other. We've had rarely, and I mean in a blue moon, we can see a 150-point move on the SPY. Sure, 1,500-point on the S&P fund index, yeah. But, I mean, catastrophic global meltdown event. For condor creators, you need to keep an eye on this thing right here, this kind of weekly spread. My recommendation to any of you out there who are thinking of doing condors on SPYs or triple Qs, another one, is I would write 1 week or less, create 1 week or less condors. Now, the good news about SPYs and triple Qs is they have expiries at least three times a week, in some cases daily expiries on options. Instead of every Friday they expire, there are options expiring every day. I think on Spider, SPY, it's every day. So my recommendation is, as a suggestion, you might want to consider writing a condor, an iron condor on SPYs or triple Qs with only 3 days. So on Mondays, you're writing condors that die on Thursday. On Tuesdays, you're writing condors that die on Friday. On Wednesday, you're writing condors that die next Monday. Thursday, next Tuesday. Friday, next Wednesday. At the longest, in some cases, you could do 48-hour condors. Mondays, they die Wednesdays. Tuesdays, they die Thursdays. Wednesdays, they die Fridays. Thursdays, Mondays. That means you could, in theory, theoretically, you could be writing condors every day that die in 2 or 3 days from now. And so in a week or two from now, you are carrying 2 or 3 different condors at the same time with different expiries. But keep this in mind. You want to have a nice wide range with a short time frame so that you maximize your profit potential, because you want to ultimately have the most boring trade in the world is what you want to have. All the contracts that you're involved with in a condor, you want them to die worthless. That's the entire objective. You're looking to create a condor that will put everyone to sleep and let you just keep the change. And it's a matter of how many you can write. That tells you how much money you're going to make. All right. Now, as of this moment, my hunch is that with interest rates where they are, inflation where it is, and not going much lower with these kind of 40% pay raise demands coming out of labor, the economy is so-so. Apple came out yesterday with a 1% lower sales number, and made more money. Margins are higher, but their gross sales are dropping. Amazon good, Apple not so good. We're seeing more evidence of a slowdown, an economic slowdown, which means, I believe, we are not going to set newer highs to any great extent here. I believe we have more danger on the downside than on the upside. Doesn't mean that the market can't go up in a day or two or a week. The market can still do it. But I believe that the upside momentum is capped around here. The downside, there's much more to it. So if you're going to create a condor, 2-day condor, 3-day condor, 1-week condor, 4-day condor, whatever you want. You can do a condor right now that expires today. I don't know if you'll get much in the way of credit, because after your commissions, I don't know what's left. You could do a condor that, you know, you can write this morning that expires Monday. If you want to just do it, you want to be through the weekend, it's up to you. My suggestion is, rather than write a condor in the middle of this range, as an example, I would write a condor where your upside might be 455 and the downside is 443. You have more to the downside. In other words, instead of $5 protection on the way up and $5 protection on the way down, you have 3 on the way up and 8 on the way down, or you have 5 on the way up and 9 on the way down. You are making your middle point more towards the downside. You're ready and you're prepared for a sudden drop in the market that comes out of left field, like we had the other day, where the market dropped 200 points on the S&P, or on the NASDAQ, and 60 points on the S&P. You want to be comfortable with a bigger drop. Another thing to remember, too, if you're looking at the option chain, if you're a condor creator, you're watching the option chain. You know something about this market that you never knew before you joined me 2 years ago. If you've taken all the classes, you now know this fact. The reality is, if you wanted to buy a contract or price out an option contract, and the market is, let's say the market is 447 on the S&P SPY contract. If the market is at 447 and you are pricing a call and pricing a put, both 447s, both same expiry date, you know, and I know that generally speaking, the call option is more expensive than the put option. Why is that? because most people think long. Most people always think buy low, sell high. That's the mentality of everything out there, buy low, sell high. And so there's a higher premium on call options than on put options. So if you're going to write a condor with a, let's say $3 of upside protection versus $7 of downside protection, or 8 upside and 12, 14 downside, okay? The call option you're writing will have a bigger premium. It might be a $3 contract or a $2.50 contract, where the put contract you're writing is further out and naturally has a lower premium. And so you're not going to get $3.50 for writing a put contract. You might get $1.75, $1.50. The put you're buying further out is cheaper. The call you're buying after you write your call is cheaper. There's a credit between the two. That's the whole point here of this entire exercise. We have 4 contracts, and there's a credit to you. At the end of the day, if the market stays flat for this 48-hour window, the call contracts are going to depreciate more and faster because they're closer to the money as a beginning position, that you did that on purpose, but they are out of the money contracts. They will expire worthless. And so their depreciation rate is fast and dramatic. The puts weren't that expensive to begin with. They're further out of the money to begin with. And so they will depreciate as well to zero, of course, but the call will depreciate in more dollars will evaporate off the call. That's the key. If the market does fall in price during your 24-hour, 36-hour, whatever deal, 48-hour deal, 72-hour deal, if you took a position where you were skewed to the downside versus the upside, so you had like 455, you were doing 455 calls and 443 puts, and the market starts to drop, the calls will quickly drop in value dramatically because they now are losing value. They're further out of the money. And every hour that goes by, they get eaten alive. You've probably noticed this already just in the last few days as first-time condo writers. On the put side, the market might go down $2 on the SPY, but the put doesn't go up $2. It goes up 50 cents, 60 cents. Why is that? Because if you've written a put contract far enough out of the money, the first $4 or $5 of drop that an SPY has, it's not even bringing the option into the money. It's still out of the money, even after $4 or $5 of droppage. And time is slipping at the same time. So the put is rising. Yay, it's getting better for us. But we're still out of the money, and oh, we're losing 4 hours, 5 hours. At the end of the first day, say you did this on a Monday with an expiry on Wednesday or Thursday, at the end of Monday, that day is gone. There's only Tuesday, Wednesday left, or Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, but Tuesday, Wednesday left, 2 days left at most on a 3-day contract. The next morning, stock market drops again, which we've seen it do here. These puts might go up another 50 cents each, 75 cents each. But those calls have gone down to a dime. They are worthless. They are now down to less than 20 cents. They were written at maybe 250 and you bought a call for $1.50. You had a dollar spread there. Both of those are down to 15, 20 cents each. They have lost it all. This is your opportunity to buy those calls back and write new calls that expire tomorrow, Wednesday, at a closer in price because the market has gone down. And you're bringing in more cash. The cash you're bringing in, the extra cash, by writing the closer in call, you'll pay more for the closer in call as well, but not as much, no, near as much. You'll bring in a credit, a larger amount of money into your hand. That will help offset the cost, if necessary, to buy back the put that is getting closer to the money because the market is coming down, to then shift to a lower price put. Remember, you bought a put as well. It also has appreciated a little bit. You might shift that one lower as well and sell it for a profit and buy a lower price put for a lower cost. There's a credit. The put that you have to buy back and rewrite, that will cost you. but you're going to get a credit from the put you've rolled on the bottom end and on the call side you've made money to help compensate you. And then, in other words, you've preserved your spread, your condor that brought you 89 cents in premium, 70%, 70 cents premium, $1.20 in premium in credit, whatever that credit amount was, is still there. And yet you've shifted your contracts to adjust for the price. The key here is if you can stay low enough on the put side because of the likelihood of the market having more downward bias than upward bias, stay that direction, the market has to move substantially to catch you, to actually catch you on the put side. And that's what you want. You want the calls to get wiped out and you want your puts to be lethargic. By the time Tuesday afternoon rolls around with Wednesday's expiry ahead of you, the puts will really be probably where you sold them for in the first place, unless they're in the money. The market may have had to drop $7 to catch your put. That's 70 S&P 500 points that the market would have to have dropped to just get you at book value. Even at that level, the put you wrote is worthless. And on Wednesday afternoon in 24 hours, it has zero value. On Wednesday morning, you've done nothing. You're still sitting there with your original position. And the market is now at 445 or whatever, and you've written 445s. That contract has a value of $1.20 and will go to zero in the next 6 hours. It's going to lose 20 cents an hour now. And the early morning shenanigans will come and go, and you will sit there with your arms folded, and you will be waiting until noon hour, till the midpoint of the day, with only 2 or 3 hours to go before you do anything. And at that point, if that contract has a 50 cent value, a book value, it's trading at 75 cents. If it's 10 cents out of the money, it's at a quarter to 30 cents. You are watching it disintegrate in front of your eyes. Now, you may decide in the last hour or two, if the market is really close to where your contract is at, you might put in a stink bid. You might put in a 21 cent stink bid to buy it out. You'll sell off the other put. You close out those calls and you're just closing out the condor. You might do a complete closeout at market. Your platform that you're using might say to you, hey, Joe, you created this condor with an 89 cent credit. If you close it out right now, there's only an 11 cent credit left and 78 cents would be yours. Well, that's $78 per set of contracts. You wrote 20 of those, just short of $1,600 profit. You wrote 10 of them, $780 in profit. You might decide, yeah, this is a great exit point I'm getting out. On the other hand, you might put in a limit order that says to your platform, take me out with a 9 cent credit, I'll buy out. Otherwise, you might go, oh, no. I'm only going to buy back the one contract that I'm worried about, and that's the put contract, the one I wrote. The one I own has value. I'm going to sell it at the end of the day for a credit. And those calls, they're worth nothing. And so you may find that you're just waiting out the time. Otherwise, if this market has lifted a little bit and you're a dollar out of the money on the closest contract that you've done here, you're going to fold your arms and go, I'm not doing anything. It's Wednesday afternoon. These die tonight. In the next 40 minutes, they die. And I don't have to do anything. I'll let them expire. I don't have to buy them back. No commissions on the way out. Thank you very much. I've written this morning, Wednesday morning, I wrote another set of condors for this Friday's expiry. And you had on Tuesday written a new condor for Thursday expiry. And you're now watching your Thursday and Friday expiry condors because you just said goodbye to your Wednesday condors. And then you're getting ready possibly on Wednesday to even write for Monday. So you wrote Monday for Thursday, Tuesday for Friday, Wednesday for Monday. And you got three sets on the go as you get more comfortable with this condor strategy. Okay. Just a few thoughts there from all of your messages and comments. Those of you who have taken the class, you're figuring out, wow, there is a lot to this. This is a whole new way for me to get involved in options that I never had before. I could never have done contracts on Tesla. I could never have done contracts on Apple or Microsoft or Adobe or on any of these expensive stocks. And now I can even write condors on the markets, SPY and triple Qs. This is a whole new game for me. And I love the idea of being involved in contracts that die within the week or every week or maximum 2 weeks. I really like the short-term thing. And the fact is that you can control the margin requirements that you need to come up with depending on what the spread level is between your puts and calls on the high end and low end. If you have a $2 spread or a $1 spread or a $5 spread, that will affect your margin requirement, but it also limits your risk to what level you want it to be. So welcome to the party, everybody. Thank you, Dingo Style, a new member. How about that? Another member, gold bagel level status. This gets you into my gold trade alert show every morning, Monday to Friday, when the markets are open at 8 o'clock. And also gets you into Wednesday Primetime Live with Uncle Bruce, 6 o'clock Eastern Time. So you have six additional telecasts that you enjoy every week, 24 additional telecasts a month for becoming a Gold Bagel member. This is why I urge you folks, if you're already a regular member of the channel, but you're going to get into this kind of stuff here, you're going to get into Condors, you're going to get into daily and weekly trading, you're going to want to be closer to the family here. A little tighter, and becoming a Gold Bagel member might be a good idea. Thank you, Douglas. Thank you for picking up a class. Douglas has picked up number 16. There he goes. He's got number 16. Todd, you picked up a class in the middle of the night last night. I got the alert this morning. Thank you guys for picking up number 16. The website has got it, stockmarketswithbruce.ca. You can order it there. The link is right in that. As soon as you make your acquisition, you get the link. If any of you have any issues with your link to the class, send me a private email at brucefarmer@hotmail.com, which is through the website or through this channel. Just send me an email. Let me know. I picked up class number 16 this morning and I can't get the link. Can you help me out? I'll make sure you get the link. All right. Fantastic, everybody. Welcome all to the program. A Dingo Style, welcome to the channel. Another Gold Bagel member has joined us, and the party continues. It's great that you're here. Any of you who have issues where you can't get the website to work, let me know. Just send me an email and we'll figure it out for you. Those of you in Canada, I'll get my chair off here. Those of you in Canada, some of you reached out to me and you've said, look, I don't use PayPal. Can I send you an electronic transfer? Well, Canadians can do that to Canadians. And so, yes, you can do an electronic transfer. The trick is to make the conversion to $150 US. You're going to need to, you might want to send me a message and say, Bruce, I want to just do an electronic transfer. How much money should I send you in Canadian money that equals $150 US? Then I will send you the direct link direct to you without the website. So you let me know. Okay, we'll figure you out. We'll get you figured out. We'll get you covered and we'll get you in there. You can catch number 16 and figure out what others are figuring out on this channel this week, that there's a new game in town and it's called making even more money than before. And so congratulations, everyone, and welcome to the show. I'm glad you're here, and it's great to have you in. We seem to be ahead about 58 points on the Dow, I think. We're up 16 on the S&P now at 4,537. So that puts the mini contract now, the ETF, at 45. Where is it? SPY. Hang on, 45. There it is, 400. And there it is, 450.81. So anybody out there with $450 contracts, you are closely watching what's happening here. The S&P is rising, putting these puts out of the money and putting the calls in the money at 450. So interesting stuff. Welcome to the show, everyone. Great to have you all here. And thank you for these thumbs ups that you're already nailing for us. I appreciate this as well. What else is going on here? I agree. Increasing housing and rent costs of living is an unstoppable force driving labor costs. I'm with you, buddy. I know it. Hawkeye is here, number 60. Chris is here at 61. The thumbs ups are coming in. Thank you. Uncle Bruce, when is the class coming out for Condors? It's out. It's out right now. Wayne Commander, funny, similar what I wrote on SPY yesterday for 39 cent credit expiring today, 441, 443, 453, 455. There you go. And we're at 450. He's right in the range and he's got a bias to the downside. This is exactly what you want to be doing. This is precisely what I'm talking about. You want to write condors for the SPY that expire Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. There is a range to consider as an idea right there. $2 spread on each side with a 443, 53, 41, 55 range. This is a really good range, and it is skewed to the downside. I like it. Well done, sir. Hector says, Matthew, it's available. Alex, number 67, good morning. AJ, my spiders, SPYs expire today. I got 446s to 460s. You're perfect. You're just brilliant. Well done. Obviously, you created these when the market was higher. You had a more than enough downside to sit here with a 450 SPY. You're at 448. You are going to just cash in. It's beautiful. I love this. Matthew says, thank you. Splayer, lovely picture and nice catch. Dingo says, Splayer. Bobby Atkinson, the spread you're talking about, Uncle Bruce, that is between the call and the put legs, or between the call leg on one side and between the put leg on the other side. Yeah, I'm trying to talk about, if you're talking about a $10 spread between the one side and the other side, instead of being having the market at the middle where you've got five on each side, you're bringing it lower, bringing it down to the put side. So bring it down. So now you have maybe $4 protection, $3.50 protection on the way up, but $6.50 on the way down, or three up, seven down. If you make it a $12 spread between high and low, you've got four up protection, eight down protection, because we're looking to protect against sudden spikes lower. That's what we're looking for. Okay. Splayer, I will order my class tomorrow and begin to study on Sunday. Good morning, says Stephen. Number 76. JD, Uncle Bruce, do you take dollars via Zelle instead of PayPal? No, I don't even know what that is. The only thing I have is PayPal, and you can use any credit card you want through PayPal. I don't believe you have to become a member of PayPal to use it. That's the best I know on that. Lorraine, Uncle Bruce, that's why I took so long to pay for my class, because I don't use PayPal. I had my son do it. It's all good. And you know, if you know someone that can help you with the PayPal transaction, and then you send me an email saying, Bruce, I want to buy class number 16. I don't have a PayPal. I have a friend of mine who does. Then have that individual either, I would recommend you have the individual send a PayPal donation to me, to my PayPal account that you see here down below all the time. Or if you send me an email, I will send the PayPal link to your relative friend, whoever's helping you out. Then that individual can make the payment. You guys will tell me, who am I sending the class to? Is it going to Lorraine? Okay, I'll send it over to Lorraine. So the payment's through, I'll do it. We'll figure out a way. All right. Larry, a good morning, all. Number 81. Welcome to the party, Charlie, from BW. JD, Lorraine, it must be on New York City, Brooklyn thing. That must be it. Wing Commander also wrote triple Qs, 368, 69s, 379, 80s, also expiring today. Same credit. Nice job, Wing Commander. A number of you have been really working on this, tinkering with this, experimenting with it, and you're getting it. Bobby, gotcha. Thank you. JD, got it. Thanks, Lorraine. I use Zelle. Splayer, for me, it works where there's only €1 on PayPal. The rest gets to my bank account debit because of the connection. Whatever works. Hector, I use MoneyGram. Amy, Wing Commander, nice job. Splayer, sometimes it takes time till money gets here from my bank account. That's true. JD, Pony Express might still work. Home Skillet, haven't used my PayPal in over 10 years. Alex, Wing Commander, top of the class again. Rock and roll. Well done, everybody. Welcome to the party, kids. We're opening in 21 minutes here. The spiders are at 450.90 right now. 450.90 at the moment. They're up 206 in the pre-market. So there you have it. That's what's going on. Other than that, let's take a look. I'm showing the markets as a whole up 54 for the Dow, 15 and a half gain on SPY or Spider, SP 500, and 75 points on NASDAQ. So we have a very strong opening here. Well, strong, a good opening, not strong. good. 0.15 on the Dow, 0.13 of a point on S&P 500, and almost a half a percentage point on NASDAQ. And that's because of Amazon particularly. Crude oil up 36 cents at the moment. Not much going on. All right. Let's see. Here's a headline. If you're earning $20 an hour in San Francisco, it's almost impossible to get by. There is a real, you know, that's a legit comment. If you're earning $20 an hour in San Francisco, it's impossible to survive. And there it is, because the cost of rent and food and everything in the service, it's insane. New York City. If you're in Manhattan and you earn 20 bucks an hour, you're living in a cardboard box. I mean, come on, let's get with the program here. We're talking, at 40 hours a week, that's $800 before tax. What are you netting out? 600 bucks? How do you get by at 600 a week in Manhattan? I don't know how you do it. Remember, you got to live 7 days in Manhattan if you're going to live in Manhattan. Don't know how it works. People obviously commute in and commute out, but that eats up the money too. And that's why people don't work for 20 bucks an hour in New York City. Kind of makes sense, doesn't it? Unbelievable. Truer stories. In Vancouver, here in Canada, it's exactly the same thing. In Vancouver, man, you have to make serious money to live there, because you're talking a one-bedroom apartment, $2,000 a month. You can't live in a $2,000 a month apartment if you're making $2,400 a month. I mean, it's No, you got to be over $4,000 a month to be able to do that. You got taxes, you got food, utilities. No, not going to happen. Anyway, there you go. Interesting economic stats coming up. All righty. The Rocket Lab seems to be up 4 cents with 18 minutes to go. SoFi is unchanged here, 10.05, 10.06. GameStop is maybe up a penny. Nothing on Matterport. 23andMe up a penny or two. Nothing else going on the other smaller stocks. Apple is down 5.56 today, down 2.8%. It's now 185.61, the all-time high 198. Goldman up 83 cents, Cisco down 25, Tesla's up 187, Arc Innovation is up 32 cents, Microsoft up 394 today to 330. Pfizer up 6, HPQ up 4, Alphabet, Google up 72 cents to 129, Amazon up 1150 to $140. Nvidia up 284, 448 bucks. It was up 246 yesterday. So the stock has gone from this 338, 333 range back to 345. Unity is up 33 cents, was down 33 yesterday. AI, C3.AI Inc. was down 59 cents yesterday. It's up 42 this morning. Adobe down 650 yesterday, up 366 right now. And the spiders are up 192, it looks like, or something like that, 136, 192. We got a gain, 191 gain on the spider, 450.75. So it's an upward bias to start the morning. The job report did not hurt the market at all. The market is actually more happy than anything else, but the unemployment rate was going to be 3.5%, 3.6 anyway, and it is. And there you go. That's the start. All right. Welcome all to the show, and I'm glad you're all here. Let's see here. A couple more comments coming through here. Let's go. Dingo is saying, I've been a lurker from day one on this channel. I'm finally a member, and welcome, my friend, to the family, the best family YouTube has right here. This is the channel, the best YouTube channel, period, for members. We love you, and it's a great family, and we do a lot of comparison of notes. People talk to each other here. We have the Discord channel. It's a pretty tight community. You're a part of it now. It's great to have you. Puke Burb, would Delta be a good metric to use when choosing the strikes in Iron Condor? If you want to get into it, but you know, you don't have to get... I try to keep it really simple. I mean, you've noticed how I don't quote betas, Greeks, meta. I don't talk that technical garbage. I just look at the market and I look at the price of the issues. I look at the highs and lows. I look at the recent chart, and then I make my move. And that's all I need to know. I just, these other metrics are you're thinking mathematical only and not emotion. And I'm trying to think emotion as well, and trend, and the feel of the market, the psychology of the market. You've got to build that into this. And that's how I do it. Wing Commander, I also wrote Disney for next Friday. I did the Disney for $79.81 and $91.93. I got a 70 cent credit. Placed a low range below recent lows. Probably not the wisest move because their earnings on Wednesday. Well, you know, if you got enough of a range, it doesn't matter. Disney, where are we at now on Diz? Disney. Here it is. It's $85.49. And you're sitting at $79.81. I think you're fine. Yeah, I think you're fine. JD, forget about it. Alex, I wrote Tesla's 300 310s and 225s and 235s expiring August 18. Interesting on Tesla. It is right now. Here we go. Tesla right now is 259. And in the pre-market, where are we at? Did I say we were up just a little bit on Tesla? I think I did. Tesla. Yeah, we're up $2 to 260.150. So sitting here with 235s, 225s to 300, and we're at 265. Yeah, I should have rolled it with the Fitch downgrade, but confused at whether to roll at a loss or only when you reach a strike price. I wouldn't roll anything right now on this thing. Unless Tesla goes down to $240 or goes up to 300, 305, I wouldn't worry about anything. Yeah. No, right now you do nothing. And enjoy the shrinkage. Home skill, Ungrus, I could donate 150 from here, your live show, as payment for number 16. I prefer you don't do it as a super chat because 30% goes to YouTube on any super chats. So it can't be on super chat. It's just too much of a hit. So if you're able to do it through PayPal or through electronic transfer, or you have someone who can help you out through PayPal somehow, I really prefer that, because in the case of PayPal, I'm paying about 4%. The cost is about 4%, whereas with YouTube, it's 30%. I don't get paid until October because they hold back until then. It's not ideal at all. AJ, Wing Commander, I did Disney last Monday, expiring today. Great minds think alike. Bobby Atkinson, TO Toronto, its estimated minimum wage needs to be $40 an hour to live in Toronto. I believe that too. Toronto and Vancouver are the two most expensive cities in Canada to live. To buy a regular house in Toronto is like San Francisco, $1.5 million and up for a two, three bedroom house. Vancouver, $1.5 million. It is insanity. Calgary, where we are here, thankfully, homes are in the 400 to 500 range and up. But in Vancouver, yeah, even townhouses in Vancouver or condos, we're talking $600,000 to $800,000 to $1 million. Like it's insane. Alex, nearly got margin called. Was a bit scary. Lesson learned was roll when red and write less time to shrinkage takes effect quicker. Yes, sir. Lorraine, Hector, a few weeks, Western Union called at 5 a.m. asking me if I signed in from a different phone, changed my debit card. They tried it again. Unbelievable. Alex, also a bison spread to the downside would have helped us discuss this a.m. There you go. Wing Commander, AJ, I stole that idea from you. JR in Buffalo today, got to see Niagara Falls for the first time. Right on, buddy. The Canadian side is the best side. Lorraine, one bedroom in Manhattan, $6,000 a month. I was lucky to buy a co-op with the lottery as an affordable housing. It takes 14 years on the list. I got it in 30 days. Boy, you were lucky. AJ, Wing Commander, I was afraid of their earnings. So I shorted at the time, May have rolled down today, 86, 87, 91, 92. Alex, one thing I'm a bit confused about is whether margin requirements for Iron Condors changes as the stock fluctuates. My margin requirement appeared to go up when the Fitch downgrade happened. I don't believe that's true. But again, I can't speak for any of these platforms. There are so many of them, and I don't know them. Alex, did anyone else notice the same thing, by the way? JD, did you ever cross paths with Stu Hart and the crew in Calgary, Alberta? See the dungeon. This is back in the 80s. This would be about 1985. Yeah, about 1984-85. I had a guy working for me at my brokerage firm that I was manager of, and he was really into Stampede Wrestling. Every Friday night was Stampede Wrestling at the Calgary Stampede. Was televised. Would be on Saturdays. It would be shown on Saturdays locally, and the show was syndicated around the world. Stampede Wrestling, unbelievable. Those days, oh god, 38 years ago, don't exist anymore. Anyway, I said to him, you know, I've always been curious to see this. He says, why don't we go out this Friday night? Let's go out this Friday. I'll take you. So I went with him to see Stampede Wrestling. Way up in the bleachers. I said, I just want to be way up high and just kind of get a feel for this. And I'm at the time 30 years of age, 31, and he's about 23, 24. And I got such a kick out of watching this craziness. I used to enjoy the stupid characters that were part of that telecast, the Hart Brothers, Honky Tonk Wayne, all these other names that I've forgotten. Ed Whalen did the play-by-play, all the crazy shenanigans going on. It was a fun time. I have to say, it was fun to watch. Nothing like it is now with WWE. I don't watch any of that stuff, but Stampede Wrestling was pretty fun. Home Skillet, Uncle Bruce, what's the process for ETF method of payment? What's the process for ETF method of payment? Electronic transfer. If you're a Canadian, if you're in Canada, you can send me funds through email. You can use my email address, bruceformative@hotmail.com, and you can do a transfer there. You might want to do a Google search on that just to double check on that. JD far out, glad I asked. JD, look at that smile, guys. Dolph, good morning, Uncle Bruce. You're not thinking fourth dimensionally. That's the problem. See, I'm just, you know. Oh, I love Honky Tonk Wayne. Oh, man, I'm going to give you so many lefts. You're going to be begging for a right. Oh, yes, yes, yes. I try and remember that little guy, that instigator. He was the leader of all the bad guys. Mr. Whalen, we're going out for a party tonight. And you're not invited. And Mr. Whalen, I don't want any part of your party. I'll be with you guys. Oh, Mr. Whalen, you can see the audiences. They're all on our side. They love us. I don't think that's what they're saying. I don't know. Not what the signs they're holding up. And Ed Whalen, the sportscaster, was doing this. And he was our play-by-play guy for the Calgary Flames. So here he is, you know, Mr. Legitimate Calgary Flames play-by-play guy. And here he is, the host of Stampede Wrestling, and Ed Whalen made a lot of money doing Stampede Wrestling, and the Harts, and all these wrestlers. Oh my God, it was a tour, a huge money maker. The television is where they made the money. There was only 500 people in the audience. 600 people were in the stands. That's all it could hold. But the television money, oh my gosh, so much fun. Let's see. Frugal City, one of the Greeks that affect options premium is affected by interest rates, RHO, I think, Alex. JD, classic. BW, Mean Gene Okerlund. Oh, there were a number of stars from Stampede Wrestling that ended up in the WWE. That's where they ended up going eventually. I just can't remember the names of some of these characters anymore. It'll all come back to me once you throw them at me. But if you ever want to see some of this goofiness, just go to YouTube and look up Stampede Wrestling. You'll find clips from the 80s, the 90s. These guys were so popular in the Caribbean too. They would go to Jamaica. They would go to Honduras. They went to Barbados. They would go on tour. Thousands of people. They'd have a parade in the capital city of these islands for these guys. They were that popular because of syndicated television. Insanity. Yeah. D Davy Boy Smith. There you go. There you go. There's another one. Alex, Frugal City. Ah, maybe that was the reason. Thank you, my friend. All right. We have 5 minutes to go, and then we start trading for the day. Thank you, those of you who have been hitting the thumbs up button for us. I appreciate this so much. Thank you for those of you who are joining up this channel, becoming Gold Bagel members. Can't thank you enough. If you're becoming a subscriber to this channel, thank you. We really keep an eye on our subscriber counts. We'd sure love to see more come through. Welcome to the party, everybody. Members, you're the best of the best. I love it when you let us know how long you've been a member of the channel as well. Thank you all for your support of this YouTuber from Calgary. Please consider becoming a member ASAP, and welcome to a pretty good bunch of people here, to say the least. We're going to go comments only for members now, which is what we do. Thank you all for your participation today. Great to have you here, and you're welcome to stay if you like it. If you want to become a member, you can start commenting with us. Use those emojis. Don't forget the knee emojis. You must honor the Knights of Knee on this channel. Otherwise, they will get you. You don't want to be making them angry. That is not a good idea. Thank you, one and all, for being through with me today, coming through with us, and joining us as well. Those of you who automatically renew your memberships, I just cannot thank you enough for that. We love you all, and like I say, we much so much appreciate you. 106 thumbs ups and counting. Here they go. They're coming in. We're going live in a little bit of time here. We'll keep an eye on this market and see what it has in mind for us. We've got 4 minutes to go, and let's just see what gives. Thank you all for being part of this family. It's great to have you. All right. There we go. Just double check here on my analytics. Make sure everything is set up properly. It looks all good. Looks like we're firing on all cylinders. Absolutely fantastic. There we go. 108 thumbs ups and counting. Keep them coming, guys. Thank you. 200 of you are here right now. Thank you for joining in on the show. Don't be a slacker. Don't let Strickland catch you in the hallway without putting the thumbs up out there. He will get you. Thank you all. Mr. Premium of the Option, good morning, and good morning to you. Thank you all. Let me know what number you are, and hope you're doing okay out there. So much appreciate you being with us. All right. Final take a peek at some of the pre-market quotations. Let's see what's going on here. I think the Dow it's got a gain going of 87 points, it looks like. We've got the Rocket Lab ahead 2 cents. SoFi's up 4. GameStop looks like it's up 3. 23 maybe up 2 pennies right now. We've got Apple down 586. We'll see if that lasts very long. I don't know if there's going to be much of a serious sell-off today. S&P's up 18. NASDAQ up 77. Oil up only 28 cents. We've got Goldman up 83. Cisco's down 37. Tesla's now up $2.06. Arc Innovation's up 41 cents. Microsoft having a good morning, up 520, 535 now. Pfizer up 3, HPQ down 9. Alphabet, the old Google, up 78. Amazon is the winner, up $12, 141 a share now, up 9.2%. Nvidia up 470 on top of the 240 yesterday. We're back to 450 a share. That was 433 yesterday, I think, at one point. Unity up 56 cents. AI is up 71 at $39.99. Adobe up 294, and the spiders of the SPY, 450.76, 450.78 up 194. So that's reflective of the S&P futures being ahead as well. There you go. We're about ready to go. Larry is going to nail the bells for us, and we'll get this party started. Maria Powell, good morning. I am number 109, Bruce, on your thumbs up meter. Thank you, Maria, for that, as you are here every day. I appreciate your thumbs up so much. All of you helping out. Thanks, guys. We appreciate it. Hit the thumbs up for us. Let YouTube know this is the channel you want to be a part of if you're going to make money in the market. We're waiting for the final moments of the pre-market to dissipate, and we'll get things started with our Friday session and say goodbye to a bunch of options at the bell today, as usual. And option writers, they win and they laugh and tell jokes. Option buyers say, shut up and deal the cards. It's a totally different room at the end of the day, every day, every week. Larry Titus, thanks, man. Here are the bells. Thank you, my friend. DQ, I'm 114, Bruce. Here come the thumbs ups. DQ, thank you, Larry Titus. Thank you guys for these thumbs ups and nailing them for us. Appreciate it. Keep them coming on. 116 now. They're on the way. We're heading for 200, we hope. And I hope you're going to have a very good day making a bunch of money in this market. If you like writing options, like making money writing options, you like making money in the markets, hit the thumbs up button and tell YouTube to send more people over here to join the party. The more people that join us, the more powerful this channel gets, the better it is for all. It's just that much better. Thank you guys for being here today. Friday, August the 4th, 2023. Apple, a slight dip in earnings or in sales, but higher earnings. Amazon surprised the street with a strong performance for the quarter, and its stock is having a wonderful time. Right now, the Dow seems to be ahead about 77, 80 points. S&P is up 16 points. NASDAQ ahead about 65 at this point in time. Oil is only up a few pennies, maybe 30 cents a barrel. Not too much going on with oil. And at the SPY, the SPYs are now sitting at 450.89. They're up $2 first thing this morning. And that has got to be devastating for options expiring today that were in the 450 range. They are getting hit. BW says, I watched a classic movie last night featuring music from one of your native sons, Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves. Kevin Costner was the only one that didn't even attempt the British accent, and he was the star. That's true. That's Hollywood for you. Absolutely. oh, man. The Dow, we're ahead now, 145. So we're getting some momentum here. Up 18.7 on S&P, 87 on NASDAQ. We're up 0.43 on the Dow and the S&P 500. NASDAQ up 0.2 percentage point. And we are climbing right now on the market. Well, that's a good sign. Spire SPY is 451.03. Triple Qs are up 228 to 376. GameStop is plus 4. SoFi plus 1. AI is up 119 to $40.48. NVIDIA is up 750 this morning to 452. Rocket Lab up 11 cents, 10 cents, 713 or so. Matterport is up 4. SmartRent is up a penny. Unity up 51. Tesla up $2. Apple down 607 at the moment at 185.10. The low this morning, 183.25. We've come back almost $2 from the low of the session. We'll see if Apple even has a down day by the time it's all said and done. Google down up 140. Google's up. Moderna down $1.28. We've got Cisco down 16. Pfizer down 17 cents. IBM up 55 cents to $145 a share on IBM. This is just about $8 away from the high of the last 52 weeks. So interesting run going on with IBM. HPQ down 3. Microsoft up 654 now to 333. A week ago, at one point, those shares were sitting at 326. We're now at 333 and climbing. We're coming back to this 338 level that we were at a little over, not even a week ago. So interesting to watch that. They did hit 360 odd, 366 for the high of the year back here in June, mid-June. So they've got $33 to recover the highs. I don't know if that's going to happen, but it is up nicely. $7 right now on Microsoft. We've got ME up 2 cents. Amazon up $11 to $140.65. Home Depot down $3. Vanek is up 85 cents, the ETF. Netflix up 246. Adobe up 450. Goldman is up 190. Boeing is up 46 cents. Meta is up $4. We've got Target up 70 cents. JP Morgan is ahead 44. Costco up 31. Walmart up 24. Make it 44. In Disney right now, $85.99. up 50 cents. American Airlines up 3 cents. DraftKings up 405 to 3404 on DraftKings. That's where we're at the moment. With the Dow up 155 on the session this morning. Right on. Bobby says, you know, Men in Tights, the spoof of Robin Hood, jokes about Kevin not trying a British accent. That actor was the first to play Robin with a British accent. Cool stuff. Lorraine, Alex, margin has its drawbacks. I have one roll outstanding on my account, and it'll clear in 5 days. She can't do something at the moment. We're up 26 on the S&P. We're up 120 on NASDAQ. $2.76 gain on the SPYs at 451. So you can see in this week's range, we're at 451 right now, which is right down the middle, but more on the downside than the upside. $6 below the high of the week, $4 off the low of the week. That gives you an idea, just the skew on the SPY and Qs. I would be looking at Condors more protection on the downside. But hey, making money is what it's all about, and I congratulate all of you out there who are doing just that. Condors are a way to make some cash. Giddy on up, I say. Indeed. Welcome to the party, everybody. Hope you're doing all right out there. We've got Apple now at 186, down 517 after dropping to 183.25. 186.13, still climbing. High of the day, 186.17. This is about the high of the day on Apple, and it's climbing even more. In interest rate land, the U.S. Treasury is at 4.12. It was almost at 4.2% this morning. We have foreign currencies. The euro is trying to gain here about a 0.75 at 110.24. The British pound is up a little bit as well, 0.75, 127.80. That's what's going on over there. On the European markets, we are mixed, down 0.25, up 0.25, not much there. And on the oil market right now, we're at 81.81 in Texas, up 26 cents a barrel, with the Dow up 127, S&P up 26, and NASDAQ up 138. And it's a good opening. It's just fine. No problems here. GameStop down 0.01. SoFi down 0.01. Nothing to worry about here. AI up 66 cents. NVIDIA up 10.60. Having another good day today. NVIDIA in the last week was as low as 3. I think it was 333. Might have been the low this past week. We're now at 355. We were in the 366, 466, 468 range over a week ago. Back a week ago, we were just in that neighborhood, which is still below the all-time high of 480. But we are climbing now from that 233 to 456. And 480 is the year high. NVIDIA is at $1.1 trillion valuation and climbing nicely today. AI stocks. Rocket Lab down 0.01. Matterport up 3.5. ATIP down 0.10. Unity up 74. AI up 82 cents. Tesla up 5.20. Apple down only now 4.36. 86.81. 187. We're coming on with Apple. This is moving markets. Google is up 298. Pfizer up 11. IBM at 145.02, up 57, climbing. And Microsoft, 797, a nice climb there. Amazon holding a lovely 1243 gain right now. So S&P, NASDAQ, Dow, all moving higher because some of these issues are on all three indexes. And they're all getting a boost right now. Tech is moving markets. That's what's happening. As we speak, welcome to the party, everybody. Charlie, when iron condos have danced around spike prices, would you recommend closing out on expiring day? Take whatever profit is available, thinking SPY puts expiring today at 450. I would say that you want to keep an eye on those positions. I'm going to guess the likelihood is that the SPY 450 puts are really going to get the crap kicked out of them today. I mean, they're out of the money now. They're dying today. They really have to be under unbearable pressure, which, you know, is the point. It should be. They should be under unbearable pressure. Let's see, the 450s that expire. Let me take a look here. Let me just get through here. My quotes are behind, by the way, so forgive me for being not as current as you guys are. But 450s that expire today are showing, last I saw, 146, 148, and they're worthless, okay? They are worthless. I'm sure and I'm certain that this quote isn't close. You guys have to tell me, what is a $450 put contract for SPY going for right now that expires today? Let me know what those are. Are those down to a quarter? What's going on? Dude, Uncle Bruce, I've got Apple sold puts on my Iron Condor 185. I'm thinking of waiting it out today. What do you think? Apple, we're now at 187.15. I think you can wait it out. I think they're going to die worthless. Stock's 187 here. I think you're going to be right. Joe, Olivia, because unlike some other Robin Hoods, I can speak with an English accent even as a kid. I thought that was such a great line, a great shot at the other Robin Hood actors. Lovely. Charlie, I don't know if you're going to have to do anything. I don't know if you have to worry about any situation whatsoever here, because I just get the impression that your contracts are dying. If anyone can give me a quote on a 450 put contract for SPY that dies today, the 4th of August, I would appreciate it. I've got 10 minute behind quotes, so I got nothing. I got jack squat. So I can't give you the exact moment here, but I got to think that these 450s are really in trouble. And the key here, my friend, is you can let them die worthless. At the moment, they are worthless, or you can wait to buy them back later today. There we go. 46 cents. That's Touchcraft. Thank you, pal. Appreciate that. 46 cents a piece. They're going to go down to nothing. They'll be down to a dime in the next hour or two. And even then, you can decide whether or not you want to take them out. Anyway, there it is. BW, Joe Oliva, confidence and sealed him in Hollywood forever. There you go. Thank you, Touchgrass, for that quote. I appreciate it. It's already up right on. There you go. Interesting markets, to say the least. 158-point gain on the Dow. Definitely improving. We've got the spiders at 451.39. So, you know, like I said, the weak range, 447 to 457, 451 on the market right now. Perfect. Just beautiful. There you have it. Okay. Q's are up 243 to 376.22. GameStop up a nickel, SoFi down a dime, AI up 33, NVIDIA up 782. All right, kids, there you go. It's a fascinating thing to watch these contracts just get eliminated from participation. It is truly stunning to watch how they crap out on the last day, the second last day. This is why if you're going to write SPY Iron Condors with 3 days to go, you can still bring in credits, bring in a nice little spread, and let the Father Time make you your money. Shrinkage is your friend and your weapon that will destroy the gamblers out there. And they're the ones who are putting it on the table. You're raking the money off. You're the casino. This is what we're talking about. Man, I'm excited for so many of you out there. You're doing the same thing with stocks. Absolutely. Take these Iron Condor trades and let's go, baby. You can take care of some business here. Many of you, I'm convinced, in the next few weeks and months will be reassessing your careers. You really are. You're going to be reassessing, what is my future in at work? Am I really going to keep working, or am I going to go this one step further and walk away from that paycheck and do this instead? Because the returns on this can be rather good. You just need to pay attention to it, and you got to ask yourself, would you rather watch the market and your wealth grow, or would you rather pound the pavement and work your butt off for 7 to 12 hours a day for your employer? Where's the upside for you, your family, your relationships, your mental health, your body? You can go for a walk and take your phone with you. So you're never out of the market. you have to ask yourself which way you want to really go with this. 451.10 on SPY now, up 226. So definitely moving in the right direction from yesterday's and the day before's direction. No doubt about that. Absolutely going the right way. All righty. Thank you all for joining in so far. It's great having you here. It's going to be one heck of a time as we get closer to expiry later today. Never a dull moment. Thank you all for your participation. 123 thumbs ups. Beautiful stuff, guys. Keep it coming. Love it. Love it. Love it. Question. Let's see here. Let's see what's going on here. Let's see. Dude, Uncle Bruce, I've got Apple sold puts in my IC. No problems there. And Touchgrass, BW, it's already. Dude, now on an Iron Condor that is 14 days to go, how would you be looking at shrinkage? My Amazon went from 75 to 25 in 4 days. I'm thinking to close it. Certainly, you can take the 50 cents and say, thank you very much. May I have another? And you can then rewrite a new Condor for as much time or less time. Different spreads based on the stock right now. This is okay. You know, sometimes making this kind of a profit, I'm assuming you had a 75 cent credit, now you only have a 25 cent credit. This is a wonderful dilemma to have. Do you want to wait all that much time to make a 25 cent return, or do you take it off the table and reestablish a new Condor? And maybe you establish a new Condor that expires next Friday and has only got 7 days. And maybe you can establish a Condor with a 75 cent spread, a dollar spread, a lot of space between up and down, reassess it. Yeah, you're in a very good position here, dude. And I commend you for it. Absolutely nothing wrong with this discussion. 173 point gain on the Dow right now. Giddy up, all. Thank you all for being here. And welcome to the party, everybody. We're almost up $3 on the SPYs, 451.77. They are moving along here. The market now, the Dow up 197, S&P up 28. So, of course, a 290 gain would make sense. If the S&P is up 28, we'd be up 290 on the ETF. NASDAQ up 104 points. Very good. Oil up 20 cents a barrel right now. All righty. Let's see. Alex says, Uncle Bruce has a great video on this topic. If you haven't seen it, all about the law of diminishing returns. AJ, Uncle Bruce, on my Disney Condors that expired today, low end in the money, 86, 87, going to need to roll down. Should I wait till one or so, or in case it really drops? Disney. Let's take a look here. Where are we at? 85.90 is the stock, right? 85.82. We are here today, just up 33 cents on this session. So you've got what? You have 86.87 on the put side is where you're at. So you're in the money right now. I see what you're saying. Okay. So your 86, which your long is in the money, 22 cents. Your 87 that your short is in the money, $1.22, right? So I would be looking at a roll now. Let me take a peek here if I can get this up. My quotes won't be as accurate as yours, obviously, but let's see. Options. These expire when? Today. Okay. All righty. There we go. 86.87s. All right, 86.87s. Okay, the 86 is showing 83 to 89 cents right now. It's gained 20 cents. The stock is up 28, but it's 83 bid, and it is going to give up some ground. The 87s are 157.69, last 147. They're up 28 cents, going to be up 38 cents at least. They are in the money, $1.21. So they got a 30 cent premium, 35 cent premium right now. Okay. So The calls that you wrote. Curious about the calls. I'm assuming they're in the 90s and they're worthless. I'm assuming. Take a look here if there's anything you can do on this. Where are we at now? 85, 79. Probably nothing much you can do over there. I mean, writing an 87 call will get to 12, 13 cents. Nothing serious. Writing an 86, I wouldn't bother because the shares are climbing ever so slightly right now. And the question here is every penny they climb, that's better for your puts. The calls aren't going to get any value whatsoever. 91.92, she says. Yeah, 91.92s. They're 2 cents. They're 2 cents each. Let them die. Fair enough. The only thing you could do is you could write an 87 for 12 cents, but I don't know if commissions will eat that up. If you wrote 86 calls, you would get 32, 36 cents. The problem with that is that the stock is only 22 cents away from being in the money, and that's too close for comfort for me for very little gain. So the put side, you've made money on the put that you bought. You're losing money on the put you wrote, right? So the key here is you've got a dollar spread on each side. Your maximum risk is $100 less your risk, right? Less your credit, correct? So you're not in a bloodbath situation where you're going to get, you know, badly hurt here. I mean, I don't know what your credit was going into this, but you have a $100 risk on this entire position. That's it, which is brilliant, absolutely brilliant move. If the shares, which they now are at 85, 84, they keep climbing, these puts will drop in value. And the key here is 87 in the hood, or is 86.50 in the neighborhood? Or is that really what we have? And will you have a break-even scenario or a slight gain? I don't know. Again, it depends on the credit you got originally when you wrote these, created this iron condor. Okay. You certainly can wait until later this afternoon if you were going to do a rewrite, to do another move. Because if you were, for example, if you sold your 86 right now and got 80 cents for it, and you were to buy an 84, it would cost you a dime, 12 cents. So you'd take 70 cents out of that one position that you're long on. On the other side, the 87, if you buy it back and you then write an 86, you will pay to do it, but the credit you get from this shift in the first contract might cover it. And you still have a call out, you still have a put ahead of the put that you're writing. 85.83. You're going to be watching this stock like a hawk, obviously. I can see why. 117 is the actual value of your $87 put. Okay. That's the actual value. 117. That's all it's worth. Last trade I saw was 147, 150. And I'm sure this thing is falling in value as we're talking here. Okay. All right. Marcus, 124. Thank you. Alex, what lesson are we talking about? Charlie asking 36 at the moment for SPY, and it's going lower. It's going to zero, my friend. It's going to, you can buy it back at like a nickel, 2 cents in not too long from now. Sit tight, my friend. AJ, I got the 91.92 calls. Alex, dude, face, it's called how much profit I should take if I write stock options, 30, 50, 75, 100%. Alex, it's a free video. It's not a class. AJ, thanks, Uncle Bruce. Right on, Amy. We'll keep an eye on this as well. We'll see how this plays out. 85.80. The low was 85.70. The high 86.07. It's been a tight range today. Would love to see it go over 86 here. 86.25, 86.30 would be great. Is that going to happen? I don't know. That would take your in-the-money put down to the less than a dollar. We'll see. This is interesting. This is really interesting. I love this. Okay. Making money even when you're losing. You got to love this. That's what we want to do here. Make money no matter what the market does. 165-point gain on the Dow. 206 gain on SPYs. 450.90 right now. Triple Q is up 113. GameStop up 17 cents, SoFi down 28, AI up 18, NVIDIA up $4. We've got Unity down 21, Apple's down 587 to 185.21 right now. Google down up 167, Moderna up 23, Cisco down a dime, Pfizer up 26, IBM up 112 to 145.56. HPQ down 11, Microsoft up 379, Amazon up 12, big ones, Home Depot down 2, Vanek up 41, and Netflix down 240, Adobe up $2, Goldman up 477, Boeing down 77 cents, Meta up $2, Target is up 115, JP Morgan up 75, Costco down 98, Walmart up 34, Disney up 22 to 85.72, up 22 cents on Disney. All right. At American Airlines, down 4 cents. DraftKings up 279 today. Having a good one. All right. Dude, for free. Well. Okay, looks like I started that video, but I didn't finish it. Okay, I'll review that. Constantine, thumbs ups, 131. Thank you, Uncle Breeze. Thank you, Constantine, for that thumbs up. 85.81 on Disney. 85.70 on Disney. Okay, we're jumping around. We're back to the lows of the day, but up 20 on the session. We got a little pullback happening in the markets. We should get rises and drops all day. That's what I'm expecting. I think economists, they will react to this job report with a mixed version. Like I say, the market likes the job report, but is it the change? Is it the biggest turnaround of all time? No. See what happens here. NASDAQ up 39 and S&P up 12.6, the Dow up 114. Interesting stuff. Disney 85.56, dropping a little bit. Again, keep an eye on this, Amy. You may end up making a move where you sell your put that you're up on to buy a lower priced put. Use the credit differential to compensate you to move from the put you wrote to the put you're going to write, dollar lower. It could be a no-cost switch between the one and the other. But as time goes by, that'll evaporate because these contracts are losing time and value. Okay, so keep an eye on this thing here. If you're going to make the move, I would do it sooner rather than later, only to lock in the best conversion price. Again, I'm just going to double check here. 86.87s, right? So the 86s were 45, 48 cents. The 87s were 120, 125. So you can certainly go down at least a dollar on the ones you own and go to 85s. You'll clear 35 cents there, and then you can go from 87s to 86s, but it will cost you probably a little more because the 87s are in the money. That's the catch right now. 85.63, or just wait this thing out and grind it out, see what happens. Again, you've protected yourself. These other two contracts, the calls, there's no value whatsoever, and I don't think you can get value unless you write an 86. You might get 30 cents for an 86 versus paying 2 pennies or a penny to buy the one back. That's 30 cents. The calls, the put switch is another 30 cent gain. That's 60 cents, which will almost cover the switch from an 87 put to an 86 put, maybe. So there you go. Just a thought. We'll watch it. We'll keep an eye on this. Let's see here. BW saying, I'm noticing an anomaly or a clue. When markets go up as of late, the US dollar, a Swedish kroner exchange rate, absolutely sells off. When markets are down, it shoots up like crazy. A bellwether in currencies, maybe. BW, markets are turning down. This is rising as I put this on chat. Only currencies I see that this is so dramatic on. Yeah, I have no idea. SSR is at 10%, right? 10% SSR, yes. Short sale restriction. Short sale restrictions are 10%. Yeah, that 10%. Okay. 125 gain on the Dow. Pardon me. There we go. 128 on the Dow, 12.9 on S&P, 35 gain on NASDAQ. We're still ahead of the market. Quarter point on the NASDAQ, 0.3 on S&P, and 0.38 on the Dow. So we got gains over there. All right. Managers here, I'm number 136. Beach Boy, I bought back SoFi August 18s for 44 cents after writing 2 days ago for 61.63. Thank you, dear gamblers, for $23,400. Please come back again. Please, please come back. SoFi loves writing options. Right on, pal. Way to go. Dow is up 133, 134. Looks like we're climbing a bit. We're now up 138 again. Disney back to is 85.63 after hitting 85.55. Disney just popping a tad. Spiders, SPYs, 450.36 up 152 at the moment. All right, GameStop up a dime, SoFi down 38 to 968, AI down 30, NVIDIA up $2, and Unity down 87 cents. Tesla down 12, Apple down $6. So some mixed markets again. Alberto, hey, I'm here. Let's get this dinero. Nice work, Beach Boy, indeed. Well done. Let's see what else is going on. Well done, everybody. Keep it going, guys. IT. Thank you, IT from New York, for the donation. I'll get you class 16. I got it. It came through and I see it, and we'll get you looked after for class 16. After the show, for sure. Those of you picking up the class on the website, if any of you have any issues with connections or links, you let me know, okay? Todd, Douglas, and Tony, you're in there. Tony, yeah, Tony's got 16, absolutely. Douglas has picked up 16, absolutely. So if any of you are having any issues with your links, you let me know. Otherwise, same to you, Todd. Thank you for those of you picking up number 16 on the website or making donations through PayPal. We'll get you looked after. And now you can start studying the art of iron condors in plain English. And let's see what can be done there. We're up 140 on the Dow again. We're climbing 146, going higher right now on the Dow. Okay. Disney 85.62, just above the low of the day at the moment. Alrighty. Apple 184.70. Let me triple check that price. 184.65. The low of the day 183.25. The high 187.38. We're in the lower third of today's range at the moment. 184.66. 184.72 on Apple. And Spire, SPY's 450.77, 449.98. We just broke under 450. 449.70 right now on the Spiders. So these 450s are in the money. 449.72 at the moment. This is the low of the session. 451.87 was the high. So we're getting a little sell-off. Could be computer program trading. Expect this kind of activity to be normal, and we could swing a dollar all the time. We're up 124 on the Dow, 6.5 on S&P, and 3.2 on NASDAQ, 449.60 on SPY right now. 85.51 on Disney, new low on the session over here. So a sell wave has been coming through the markets again, and it's option expiry Friday. What more do you expect? We can expect to see this. Those 450 puts for Spider, SPYs, they're 37 cents in the money. They'll rise up to 50-60 for a bit, but if this SPY breaks 450 again, they will crap down to 10-15 cents. So those of you who are into those, keep an eye on that. 449.37 right now, as we see a little sell wave going through the markets. The Dow right at the moment is ahead 110, S&P up 391, NASDAQ went negative 2.5. Hang on one second, I'm yelling up against the lawnmower.
got to stop that.
I have enough to fight, let alone lawnmowers outside the window. 8:05 in the morning, lawnmowers start up around here. What can I say? We're up 111 on the Dow. SPYs are 449.54, still up 71 cents on the session. Qs are down 23 cents at the moment. GameStop up 7. SoFi is at 41 cent loss, 81. AI is down 80 cents. NVIDIA up 30. We have Apple right now at down 634 to 184.83. We got Tesla down $1.40. And Disney 85.49, new low of the session right now on Disney. That's what we have at 10:05 Eastern time right at the moment. All right, everyone. Welcome to Option Expiry Friday, where there's all kinds of shenanigans going on. And those of you who are doing these iron condors, you're watching this little range very closely. And there you go. This is what it's about. Okay. Hey, Alberto says, Beach Boy manager, Uncle Bruce just wrote cash secured put 107.5 for Jan 24 for 62 cents. I'm going to be selling more cash secured puts if SoFi drops further. Good move. Okay. 7.5. I see what you're doing. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well out of the money. That's an easy 62 cents. The key here is if the stock bumps a little bit, pops a bit, you're going to get 10, 20 cents contract profit easily. But it's only $2,000. If you were writing eights or nines, that would still be an out of the money write, but higher premium requirement. You would have brought bigger premium in, but you're on the right side of this trade, manager. You definitely are. Beach Boy, heads up, Uncle Bruce just heard we can begin now. It's legal. We can begin now. We can start the show now.
Okay.
Alberto's here. Beach Boy's here. We can begin. Beach Boy announced that he bought back SoFi August 18 calls that he wrote.
Mm-hmm.
He wrote them for 44 cents after wrote them 2 days ago. We sold them for 61 to 63. Just bought them for 44. Thank you, gamblers, for $23,400. So Beach Boy's doing okay. Well done, sir.
Beach Boy's had an okay week.
BW, want to see it yourself? Look at U.S. dollars, SEK on your platforms under FX. Very volatile markets there. Talking about Swedish currencies here. Mr. Premier, the option, Carl Icahn's IEP is getting smoked today. Should I sell some cash secured puts? I don't know if I want to go there. There's a huge battle royale going on between him and some hedge funds who are shorting the bejesus out of this guy. Ooh. He's doing financing to work these premiums. I am very cautious on this one. Beach Boy, yo, Mr. Premium. Manager, which strike for on cash secured puts for IEP? Manager is asking. BW, and here comes the sell waves. Friday expiry and Uncle Bruce, look how many puts they're going to get in the money on Apple for today. They wiped out all the calls in after hours last night. Elevator with Rugman is headed down, says BW. Alberto. BW, Alberto, yo, here with Rugman, BW, Beach Boy. Alberto says, BW, let's go. BW, 4,500 is big support for SPX. If it breaks below that, look out below. Next support, 4,585-ish. There we are. Spire, SPYs are 449.22, up 38. Qs are down 27 cents. Dow is up 44 points and slipping still. The Standard Poor 500 index is up 99.99 right now. Okay. Disney, 85.54. It crapped out at 85.45. It's now 85.55. So Disney has bumped up already. Still up 6 cents on the day. And BW, Auntie Jen, you sound a little tired this morning. Is all well?
Yeah,
she's fine.
It's a little smoky today.
Oh, is it?
So that maybe gets the old vocal cords going.
That could be affecting me too. I've been trying to hydrate here.
Yeah. So, don't like the landscapers?
Yeah, I love the landscapers. It's just that their equipment gas-powered equipment echoing off the walls of our outside building here. It's all I need. Not. I don't need this crap. This bunk, man. Oh, my gosh. We have 138 thumbs ups. Thank you, guys. Excellent. For coming through first. If you're happy it's Friday, give us a thumbs up.
Do you know that
if you like pie, give us a thumbs up.
Well, come on now.
Come on. And if you're if you're happy Auntie Jen is here, you think you could give us a thumbs up that Auntie Jen has come here to say hi to you. I mean, what more do you want from me? Come on, man.
It's a long weekend here.
Here?
Yeah. This is our August long weekend.
Oh, I'm working.
Because the 1st of August was Tuesday. This is as far away as we get from the 1st of August.
Oh, I guess you're right. Yeah, the first weekend of August is a national holiday in Canada.
The 1st of August.
Well, the first Monday. The first Monday of August is a national holiday. What do we call it?
The August holiday.
We don't have an official...
It's just a civic holiday.
Yeah. So, yeah. You know, we get a July holiday. We get an August holiday. We get a September holiday. October is Remembrance Day, Thanksgiving, and then Remembrance Day in November, which is quasi, some get it, some don't.
Yeah.
And then December.
We don't have January. We have our February.
Is Family Day.
We need a holiday in February.
March is Easter. Well,
maybe.
March is.
Quirky. March and April, we have Easter in there somewhere.
Yeah. And then. April for sure, then May, then June, nothing, July, August.
Yeah. July 1st, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Interesting. Former first-round NBA draft pick is sentenced to 10 years in prison for $4 million of health care fraud.
Whoa.
Well, there you go. Isn't that something? I don't know who it is, and I don't know what the crime is. I just read the headline. It's just a headline. Comments coming through here. Richard Carlin, good morning, Auntie Jen.
Good morning, Richie.
Splair, just in case, wishing you all, including Jen, a great and relaxed weekend. Thank you, Splair.
Thank you. Same to you, Splair.
Wing Commander, SPY Iron Condor is now 80% in profit.
Yes.
The Triple Q's Condors, 70% in less than 24 hours.
See?
Dude, his face says thumbs up, Auntie Jen. Nice, who cares? Dude. Joining late this morning at number 138. Cindy B. Uncle Bruce, any opinion on PayPal? I have the stock and sold cover calls, but it took a dip after earnings. Oh, you've got PayPal stock. I have the stock and I sold cover calls, but it took a dip after earnings. So you sold cover calls, thinking of selling the stock for a loss and buying a long covered call for a poor man covered. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
You're buying it deep in the money. You think about getting deep in the money calls on PayPal and then writing
more. And writing more.
Nothing wrong with that strategy. Down. Yeah. If you can work it that you can buy deep in the money calls and get two for every 100 shares, sell 100 shares, get two deep in the monies. So you can now write double the number of contracts.
Right.
I would look into that. Or as close as, because even if you can buy one and a half deep in the monies or 1 3/4, you can write the first call, get the premium, and then get enough to buy the buy that second deep in the money call and now write it.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Wing Commander, these 10 iron condos would pay for Uncle Bruce's classes two times over. Thank you so much. All of my classes or just one of my classes two times over? Or
is it
all of my classes? Well, he's doing 10, so I gotta think he's all the classes. Well done, Wing Commander. Dude, Auntie Jen, God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold, says dude.
We'd fire no guns. We'd shed no tears. We'd
shed no tears.
Now I'm a broken man on a Halifax.
See what you started here?
The last of Barrett's
private tears. Zach, number 141. Good morning, Auntie Jen. Splair, thanks, Auntie Jen. BW, Google is offering an on-campus hotel special to help lure workers back to the office. Google is offering a summer special for employees to stay the night at an on-campus hotel for a discount. That's an interesting comment. Constantine, have a great weekend, Uncle Bruce and Auntie Jen. Have a great weekend, everyone. Thumbs to all from Constantine. John Anderson, happy Friday to Jen. Bobby Atkinson. It's the civic holiday, Labor's Day in September. That's right. BW, that's Wing Commander, Sega. Nice. Jeez, that's way to go there, buddy. Dude, we'd sing that on the road trips with Dad. Thanks, Andy Jed. There you go. He was.
That's a good one. It's a very long song.
Oh, is it ever? Yeah, that's true. We're now a little better on the market. We're up 76 on the Dow, 30 points better. SPY still up 63 cents, 449.47. Triple Qs have gone positive, up 2. GameStop up 22. SoFi down 31. That's actually improving. AI down 116. NVIDIA down 131. Disney, 85.64. Looks like we have got a 19 cent jump off the lows. 85.65 up 20 now, up 16 cents on the day on Disney. We got a few people with iron condors
watching
all kinds of stuff. It's all exciting and it's all happening and it's all going at the same time. And
doesn't Disney have a new movie? Well, they've got their haunted house.
Yes, that's true. That's true.
But don't they own Barbie? Didn't they do the Barbie movie?
I don't know if Disney did Barbie. I don't know. I don't think so. A manager, Uncle Bruce, I sold 10 cash secured puts on United Healthcare. These were 470 strikes for 1105, covered on the run up today for 1030. And I bagged $967 for overnight hold. Not bad, eh? What's wrong with $960 overnight? Nothing.
To sleep.
You get paid to sleep. A Beach Boy wrote SoFi October 10s. Some time ago for 106, just sold some more for 118. Who are these gamblers? Writing cash secured puts. Giddy up, buddy. Zach, hey, Uncle B, the other day you were trying to remember who did the Rugman art. It was me, Zach. Thank you. Is your name anywhere on this artwork? I don't even know, Zach.
Is it down in the corner? What's that little red thing down in the corner? Does that say Zach anywhere?
Yeah, Z. G is it? 2022, right?
There you go. Nice.
Yeah.
He's gotta put his stamp.
I don't have it on the bottom of my mug. It didn't pick up there, but it picked up on the
weird.
But it doesn't say Zach, it just says ZG.
Yeah.
But there's Zach G right there, right on Zach. Thank you, my friend. Fantastic, buddy. I love that you're here always. Let's make money. 85.62 on Disney, the Dow up 59. We're wavering along here, just kind of meandering. Spiders are 449.54. Charlie is watching those 450 puts with a hawk, an eagle eye. He's watching those. Fun times. Always fun times as we come into the last hours of the day. We're slowly approaching halftime.
You moved your light up.
It's way up, yeah. Yeah, I did it way up here.
Nice.
I left it there from the class.
Oh, I see.
Because I didn't want to have reflection behind my head.
Today I noticed it.
On this? Yeah.
Only
took you a week. Is that great?
Is that a mustache?
Zach, there it is. That's right. There it is. Thanks, Zach. We have new joiners today for the Gold Bagel membership. Oh, we have two new joiners today.
Excellent.
We have 142 thumbs ups today. Thank you all so much for being part of this. We welcome Dingo Style as a Gold Bagel member. Dingo's in the house.
The Dingo.
DS and Charlie joined today.
And Charlie.
CC. So CC is here. DS is here. Thank you.
Sorry, Charlie.
No, that's not it. That's not that guy. Mr. C is here. Thank you guys for becoming Gold Bagel members of the channel. Thank you for these 143 thumbs ups and counting.
Yeah.
Jen appreciates it. We appreciate it. People have been picking up the classes today. They've been picking them up off of PayPal. They're sending us PayPal donations so we can send them the links.
We talk about this all the time, how that
on Gmail.
The comments and the questions they have now.
Oh my God. Yeah.
It's a delight to give people information and watch them run with
it. That's right.
Yeah.
That's exactly right. Dean, we got your donation through the website. You got your class. Hopefully the link's okay. Tony, Douglas, Todd, all today. And then we had a fellow pick them up here through PayPal, which I only mentioned the initials. Giddy up. Mr. IT from New York.
Mr. IT.
79th Street.
He's a popular guy.
IT. IT's in the house. We got IT in the house. No problem. It's all good around here. We got IT in the house. Thank you guys for this. Absolutely. 144 thumbs ups and counting. And what does this say? Bobby Atkinson, Barbie is Mattel, nothing to do with Disney. Yeah, we were thinking about the movie. Who made the movie?
See, I just assumed Disney owns everything.
Yeah. See, Beach Boy says, Zach G, smoking hot, man, you rock. Hector, AI just took a dive, says Hector. We've got, let's see, here we go. AI right now down 82 cents. BW Zach, it's awesome. Getting a poster ordered as soon as I get my first 30% AI Poor Man Cover Call buyback. Promised myself that. Not much, but will be an awesome conversation piece in my home. Yes. Asset manager's office. Charlie C says, I'm the OW Charlie Bit Me guy. Ow, Charlie Bit Me guy.
Oh, you're the ow, Charlie ow. Bit Me. Not sorry, Charlie. Sarkis only wants good tuna.
Charlie, dude, Zach G, I got your art on my coffee mug, man. I got your art on my coffee mug. I know I have this one on my travel mug, and I have a coffee mug with this on
it
as well.
And we have the little refrigerator magnet.
And I got my t-shirt, and we have a refrigerator magnet. We ordered all kinds of stuff with that logo on.
I love it.
Manager, I predict at least $20-$30 drop on Unity, United Health to $470 from today till the end of August. If anyone interested is taking on a trade, says manager, he thinks it's going
to
roll.
See how
hold them to it. We're moving up on the Dow, though. We're up 93 now on the Dow. We've climbed a bit here.
Well, it's Friday.
We're going to see this. you know, you're going to get these swings. We're up 10 now on S&P. NASDAQ is up 38. So as Spider, the SPYs are 499.94. The 450 put is worth 6 cents in book value.
449.94.
It's worth 6 cents. Charlie, you're going to be just there. It is 450.04. It's there worthless. The put is worthless, Charlie. You got nothing to worry about. It's all good, Charlie. Man. It's all good.
We love you, Charlie.
Oh man, manager says, oh, that Charlie bit me. I watched the old one and the new one is hilarious. Zach, thanks, gang. I'm glad the rug man has been so appreciated. BW manager, though, those are big boy shares. I see, I am sure they are. Charlie, SPY is messing with me. 449.95. That's right.
You got him on his hook.
You are paying the price for not doing that rollover I talked to you about yesterday. You didn't want to do it, and now you're on the line.
Yeah.
They're messing with it. You're gonna be all right. I think you're gonna be okay. Wow, what a day! Unbelievable.
Have a great weekend, everybody. Nice long weekend to all those Canadians.
Jen, we got you up to 144 thumbs up. So right. About 10 came in because you're here.
Those
guns, don't mess with those guns. She's showing off her guns right now. Look out. Thank you, Auntie Jen. Catch you later. Yes, kids, welcome to the party, pal. And glad to have you here. Thanks for joining us and being part of this family, becoming members of this channel, renewing your memberships, everything. We're just so glad you guys are here. This is good stuff. Watching these contracts and keep an eye on just where they end up as the day wears on. Oh my gosh. Yes, sir, Charlie. They are definitely right at the level. You're out of the money, 11 cents now. At Disney, 85.74. Going up again. Disney moving higher. Thank you very much, Disney. Cindy wants those to go higher, please. And thank you. Clay, playing with the SPY with short-term options is how you give yourself an anxiety disorder and acid reflux. Clay, depending on the week, that is, that's true. And depending on your positions, this is why you want to be on the downside with your spread. You want to be linking that way always for nasty surprises. 450.17 on SPY. Those 450 contracts Charlie has, those puts he wrote, they're out of the money. They're worthless now, Charlie. They have no value. The question is, what are they trading at? That's the key now. Wing Commander YouTube ate my comment. 10 condors I wrote yesterday pay for two classes. So I got 39 cents times 10. But that is just me trying this thing out. There's always next week. That's true, my friend. Charlie, where's my bottle of Tums? I know where mine is. I got mine right here, the big boy bottle. Yeah, I'm okay. I got my Tums. Oh, my, my. Too early for day drinking, Charlie? Is it too early for day drinking? 450, 26, 26 cents out of the money now. The Dow's up 110. The SPYs are out of the money. 85, 84 on Disney. It's now almost 40 cents off the low of the session. That's good news for Cindy and her puts, her 87 puts and her 86 puts. Interesting to see this. Clay, I know it was a wrong day to quit sniffing glue. I knew it. Spicy, I'm 138 today. Dude, I closed my Amazon Iron Condors, took profits, rolled into a new one, took 90 cent credit for that, expiring in 7 days plus, 40 cents after the roll, stacking the premium. Well done, dude. Well done. There it is. Folks are getting more smarter all the time, craftier all the time. I love this. 450, 41 on SPY, 41 cents out of the money on those 450s. Looking good for Charlie now. Looking very good for Charlie. Disney 85, 92, climbing again on Disney as well. All right, giddy up. We're up 85 cents on triple Qs. 123 point gain on the Dow now. Improving, indeed improving. Oil up 26 cents. That's it. Mega Millions jackpot reaches $1.25 billion. Those are the biggest lottery prizes. These are going to be the biggest lottery prizes in U.S. history. Unbelievable. Spicy, would it be a good idea to write a call on a company, then do an iron condor on the same company with the money you took in from the call? Yeah. Yeah, sure. You can do that. You can double stack it. Absolutely. Just give yourself a nice wide berth. Dude, SPY seems to be the best for iron condors. I'm thinking it might add to that position next week. You can write two-day condors, three-day condors, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Pick the length, pick the spread, take the credit, and run. Stay on top of it. It's very liquid. I like really short term on those. 450.32 on SPY, 85.94, 85.96 on Disney. Climbing again, 50 cents off the low in the last 30 minutes. Disney coming on. Good news for Cindy on her $87 put contract. She's looking better than she was half an hour ago by far. Okay. All right. Interesting session to say the least here, kids. Are you having fun? You Iron Condor creators, are you having fun out there? What a session. What a session. 450.12 on those SPYs. We're getting back to that 450 level. That's not good for Charlie's Tum intake meter. That might be tough. We'll watch for this. Let's take a look and see what we get. Condors are like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. What can I say? Options expiring today. The 450s, as of 10 minutes ago, the 450 put contracts, am I correct in assuming they were 116? Had they climbed back up to that level? August 4 expiry. There we are. 10 minutes ago, the 450s were showing 116. The 449s were 72. The 448s were 43 cents. 447s were 24. The 446s were 13. Out of the money, out of the money. 450, 18 on the SPY ETF. And the 450s are now, last I see, 115 last trade at this point. Hector, neat, neat, neat. Charlie, fun isn't the word I'm choosing at the moment. Amy, the Disney Iron Condors are mine, Uncle Bruce, not Cindy's. Oh, AJ, sorry. Thank you, Amy. I got so many people doing so many things. It's not easy for me. Charlie, 450s are showing 86 bid ask, 86 cents now. Okay, so they're falling again. Again, they're shrinking out, buddy. They're shrinking. They're not worth anything. They're 21 cents out of the money. They are worthless. They will be zero if this thing stays 450 or higher. So there is shrinkage coming. It's coming your way. stand by to enjoy the party, the goodness, the happiness, the good times, Splare, and neat, 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 neat. There you go. A little encouragement for you, Charlie. Time to put an option, put a knee attack out there on those SPYs. Time to get the knee emojis going. Neat, 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 right there. And that'll put the spell on the SPY for sure. 450.22. Disney will go to the moon. Giddy up, everybody. This is what we want here for everyone. Everyone to be making nothing but money each and every time. 85.95 on Disney. Splare. Neat, neat. Richard Carlin. Neat, neat. D.H. Ruda. Neat, 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 neat. Here they come. Can't stop the knee emojis now. The attack is underway. And get out of the way, markets. Yeah, you're only going to get hurt out there. 450.48 on Spire. Going, Spider's going down. Edith. Neat, 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 neat. Big E. The Big E. Edith. Edith. The Big E's here. Welcome all to the knee emoji attack. It's underway. Fun times. Disney, $86. That's good stuff, AJ. 86 and climbing. Deep value. Neat, neat. Karen, neat, neat, neat. Larry Titus, neat, 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 neat. There they go. They're coming in from all over the globe, all over America, all over Canada, all over Europe. Here come the knee emoji attacks. You can't, don't get in the way of the knee emoji attacks. You're just going to get stumped. 151 thumbs ups. Thank you, everybody. Keep them coming in, folks. Here we go. Disney, go. Disney, go. 8601. 450.72 on Spire SPYs. Charlie, you're laughing, baby. You're laughing now. Here we go. Nat Matthew, thank you. Larry Titus, here we go. Neat, neat, Nico. Neat, 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 Zach. Neat, 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 neat. It's happening. Disney 8602 going higher. Disney's going higher. Those put people who are gambling on long positions are nervous. Those who are on the short side are nervous. We're 98 cents in the money. That's all on those 87s. Giddy up, everybody. 8606 was the 8606 has been the high of the day for the stock, and we're just about there on Disney. That is the story right now. 8607, new high on Disney. Here we go. Amy is loving this. Splare, I hear all the shaking bus sounds and the neat, 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 neat. Charlie, stink bit at 11 cents. Come on, baby. Oh, it's coming your way. You're at 90 cents out of the money now. They're going to crash. They're going to crash. You can go 6 cents on those. Dean, neat, 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 neat. So much fun. Is everyone having a good time? I'm having a good time. It's fun watching you guys play this market. This is good stuff. Let's go, baby. Taking the money from the innocents. 8609 on Disney going up again. 8610. Here it's coming. 86. Here goes Disney. Giddy up, everybody. Thank you all for being part of this this show today and this crazy time. We're having fun till daddy takes the T-bird away. SPY 451, a dollar out of the money there. Oh, Charlie, they're gone now. They're gone now. They're gonna crap right out to nothing now. It's over. Oh, this is good stuff, Charlie. You're doing great. Well done, sir. Making some money. Karim, neat, neat. Splare, again, have a good weekend, everybody. Neat, 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 neat. Hector, nothing positive about you or AI. Nothing. Nothing is positive. Disney 8606. AI right now is down $1.05, and Unity is down 69.70 cents. The Dow is up 160. SPY up $2. Nice, nice, nice. Good stuff. These 450s are losing their shirts. I am sure. Expiring August 4. 450s are now sitting at, well, my quote is obviously way behind. I'm still soaring 120. I'm sure they're sitting at 25, 30 cents, if that. Congratulations, everybody. And way to go, Charlie. Way to go. Good stuff. Looks like Kremlin foe Alexei Navalny has been given just another 19-year prison sentence on top of all the prison sentences he's got. So he probably won't be able to run for president against Putin for another lifetime. There you go. First, you poison the guy. then you put him in prison forever. There you go. 19 years. There you go on another trumped up charge. And there are businesses doing business in Russia. Unbelievable with this nonsense going on. Blows my mind. What can I say? It is crazy. Well, there you have it. SPY, what can I say? The SPYs are 450.97 right now. There you have it. 451.01 going up again. Giddy up, everybody. Hope you're having fun out there. Staying on top of this market. Man, oh, man, oh, man. All righty. Giddy up, everybody. Welcome to the party, pals. Thank you for the 152 thumbs ups. Keep them coming in if you can. Appreciate it. And let's watch some of these other markets here. August 4th expiry, 450s. I'm not showing them at 96 cents from 10 minutes ago, so I am way behind on this. The 449s 10 minutes ago were 59 cents. The 448s were 34. I'm sure that these 450s are crapping out quickly. If anyone sees a 450, let me know what they're going for now. Okay, and let's go over here to Disney. 86.13 on Disney now. High of the day, 86.13. Very good. This is definitely adding to the fall off of put values on the Disney contracts. Look at that, 86.13, up 64 now for the day. 86.14, there you go. High of the day right now, 86.14. Thank you for the 153 thumbs ups, everybody. Thank you for being here with us today. Jen and I, thank you very much. Those of you picking up class 16, let me know if you have any issues with the links. Thank you for that. Study the Iron Condors this weekend. Take that class, watch that class, and understand how this game works. 86.17 now on Disney, climbing again. Spires, SPY's 450.95. You can see here for the week range, 447 to 457. Right now, 451 is the range. This makes Iron Condor writing very profitable. Well done, all of you who are taking advantage of these credits, taking the money from the gamblers on the floor of the casino. It sounds like nickels and dimes. You would think, geez, only bringing in $49 credit, bringing in $86 credit. What's the point? Well, if you write 20 of them, you're bringing in $1,700. And 3 days later, it's all yours. How about that? Why not do that 4 or 5 times a month? And think about the kind of money that represents versus your day job. $100,000 a year making 80 cent credits. What? How does he do that? What are you talking about? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Making $8,000 a month and more on just 20 contracts. That's a $10,000, not even a $10,000 margin requirement. Hello. Say goodbye to the day job sooner rather than later if this is going to keep up here. Folks, why not take this action and say, thank you, sir. May I have another? All right, everybody. Thank you all for popping through today and seeing us. It was great having you. Make sure to honor the knee emojis and keep your eyes on your Iron Condors. And any of you looking for one-on-ones, you let me know. Send me a private email. We'll see when we can get together with you. And we'll do that. Thank you again for all of you doing the classes and one-on-ones and becoming members and being part of this great family of YouTubers. It is much, much appreciated. We're up 185 on the Dow. SPY's 451.07, up 220 today. Q's are up 186 now. GameStop up 49 cents. SoFi is coming on 982, only down 24 cents. AI down 111 at 38.17. The low was 37.80. A little better now. Cash secured put time. NVIDIA up 578 back to 451. We got what else here? Unity down 64 cents. Looks like it's coming back. Tesla down only 29 cents. Apple down 568 at 185.49. Google up 129. Moderna up 127. IBM up 82. Microsoft up 517. Amazon up 1350 to 142.45. There you go. Disney at 86.22, climbing again. up 73-74 cents on Disney as it is climbing as well. DraftKings 241 gain 32-40 today. There you have it. Hope you enjoyed the show. Hope you found something new today. Hope you learned something new and trading something new and trading something well. Thanks for everything, AJ. You got it. Keep it going there. Richard, neat. Matthew, thank you, Uncle B. Great show today. John Anderson, thanks, everybody. Have a great weekend. All of you have a wonderful weekend. Give someone you love a big, long hug this weekend. You never know when's the last time. Disney, 86.25. It's popping. Here goes Disney. Giddy up. We'll take this game. And SPY is 450.93. Way to go, Charlie. Way to go, AJ. Way to go, everybody out there. Keep up the good work. Fantastic. Heat map slowly changing from green to dark brown, slowly going to close red on most indices, in my opinion, says BW. John Anderson, neat. Dude, thank you, Uncle B. BW, dollar signs everywhere. Here we go. Keep it all up, guys. We'll see you first thing Monday morning for you Gold Bagel members right there for the Trade Alert Show. If anything crazy happens in the next few hours, I'll break in with a video. Otherwise, we'll see you Monday. Thanks again for everything, guys. 86.28 on Disney. Go, Disney, go. Fantastic. Have a good one, all. Talk to you later. Bye for now.